Welcome to another installment of Suave Life TV. I am your host, Emmy Ikpe, aka Lord Suave, with the lovely Brytnei Elle.
Hi, everybody.
We have some great topics to talk about, so we'll just get into it right now.
Yes, we do.
Happy day, happy life. We just had a great glass of wine. Wasn't that wine amazing? What was that we were drinking?
It was Alemana Chablis.
Oh, wow. All of that good stuff. See, we're wine experts, but I've never had that wine before, so now I'm feeling a little bit good.
Best wine is Marcus James Riesling, the Argentinian kind. That's another conversation.
I hear a lot of good things about that wine, but I'm not sure I've ever had that wine.
It's a life changer.
What's going on in the news today, Brytnei? What's up?
There's a lot of things going on. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've talked about the Ebola situation. Yeah. We've talked about so much stuff going on with people's personal lives.
Right. Speaking of Ebola, though, somebody just was recently released or something?
Yes. There was a couple minutes ago, a message, story that came out saying that a reporter in Nebraska was cleared to leave the hospital for Ebola contamination. Basically, he's not showing any symptoms. Like, he's asymptomatic now at this point, so I'm thinking that's a good thing, but because, I mean, some people's blood type and their system, their immune system, is able to fight off Ebola without any other interventions from modern medicine. But I don't know. Some people are passing, as Thomas Duncan did. So I know that there's a lot of back and forth about this Ebola thing. People say that certain things are conspiracy theories. I saw something online today that said that the Ebola virus has the Ebola vaccine is basically being given to people because it has RFID chips within the syringe.
Oh, but so
it's basically a way
tracking
of
people.
Tracking people.
So this, tracking devices.
So it's kind of the same way as, like, you kind of get people acclimated to a certain system where they're able to get, the flu shot.
Right.
And I've only had one flu shot in my life. I'll never do it again. I didn't like how it made me feel.
So you don't get it every year?
I had it one time my entire life.
That's cool. Neither do I. I definitely don't do it. I think I have a pretty good immune system. A lot of vitamin C is what I take, so.
A lot of bourbon and tea and lemon. It burns it out.
My hot dad toddy? Used to make is that me a hot toddy?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
My daddy makes me the best hot toddy when I'm home, and if I'm sick, it's like, drink that, you get under some blankets, call it a day. You're good. It works, people.
Oh, okay.
We'll put a recipe up.
Yeah, we'll definitely give you a hot toddy recipe.
Thank me later, okay?
Oh, Drake said it. Thank me later. Speaking of Drake just dropped a brand new track a couple of days ago.
What's
Have you
song?
Heard of it?
No.
It's like, you're the one or something like that? I don't know. I might be saying it wrong. I'm not sure. But I heard it is hot. I haven't heard it just yet, but when I get the information, I'll definitely give it.
We're going to give him like 30 seconds, like not even 30, we're going to give him 15 seconds of it real quick?
Yeah, I'll give you a quick clip of it. Drake is a man, period.
Okay, so they get a little 15 seconds, and they hear that.
Yeah. Okay. I like what you got going on today. You all like Michael Jackson-esque.
This is Michael Jackson-esque at the same time. Rest in peace, Oscar De La Renta.
Yeah.
My attire is inspired by the phenomenal designer that he is. Fun fact of the day, did you know that he was the only designer to style every single first lady since Jackie Onassis? Yeah.
It's Jackie Kennedy?
Well, she was Jackie Onassis first.
Well, I knew her
as Jackie
Kennedy.
But that's why she's
Kennedy.
Called Jackie O.
Oh.
So she was Jackie Onassis with the pillbox hat, the fly suits. He died from cancer at the age of 82, I believe, earlier.
Yeah.
In the morning, so rest in peace and prayers obviously out to his family and everyone else. He has made an impeccable impact in the fashion world.
Oh, phenomenal.
So
people are mourning this man's death. And when I heard about it, I was like, are you serious? I had to Google it to make sure that it was true. Because you know how social media is killing off celebrities.
All day, every day.
Every single day. So I had to do it. But the Drake track is actually called How About Now. We'll play it for you later, but I just had to put that out there. But back to, Oscar De La Renta.
Yes.
And Kanye West was a huge fan of his work as well. Mm-hmm. So, and I'm a huge fan of Kanye. So.
Shout out to Kanye. Shout out to Kim Kardashian, his wife, whose birthday is today.
Oh, it is her birthday.
Shout out to his former boo, Amber, because it's her birthday today, too.
Are you serious?
I see you, Kanye.
Oh, I see what you did there, Yeezy. I see what you did there, Yeezy. That's funny. I did not know
it's
that, yo.
Birthdays.
Wow.
Yeah. So.
Wow.
C'est la vie. Things happen, you know, coincidences or not.
Wow.
I left the jar.
Oh, you definitely left the jar too. So remember, we have a jar. Whenever you say one of these terms or quotes that everybody is saying that we no longer want to say, you got to put a dollar in the jar. So you should just put a dollar up. Like, that's what you should really, really just do.
I got y'all. It's figurative.
Oh, okay.
Slapped on the table, okay?
Halloween is coming up. And I'm sure that people are going to be ODing with costumes that you should not wear. I'm sure they are. So there's this guy. I don't know who he is. And I couldn't get a name. But basically, he wore the Ray Rice uniform or costume. And basically, he has like a blow-up doll, and he's dragging a blow-up doll everywhere. Is that funny, or is that funny? Do we have a video or a clip of it?
We have a picture of it. I just pulled it up online.
Let's take a look at it.
Let's go in. Let's get closer. Let's look at it. We've got the gentleman here. At least, I'm happy to say he's not in blackface. We have another picture, I believe, you can see him here. And I don't know who these other people are in the back. I don't know what
they're doing. It's a Halloween party.
I mean, but they're early as far as I'm
concerned. They're extremely early. Cause
but, you know, yeah, that's the girl being dragged. It's in poor taste. It's the same way as being just as negative as going into... It's the same way as being as negative, in my opinion, of going into blackface.
Okay.
Because it's just, it's something where somebody has been scarred, hurt, a group of people have been negatively impacted by the actions or behaviors of certain individuals, and now you're basically making light of it.
Right.
No bueno.
So, what's going on? What is going on in your world, Brytnei?
Well, I mean, as far as what? Like, things that I've just noticed, paying attention to.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm very excited to hear about this wonderful development.
Okay.
Male birth control.
Wait, what? Male birth control?
Male birth control. And.
No. But I'll let you keep going.
It makes a lot more sense to unload a gun than to shoot a bulletproof vest.
Wow. Who taught you that? Just let that marinate.
I know you wasn't ready for that.
It makes a lot more sense
to unload a gun than to shoot a bulletproof vest.
I'm just going to say absolutely not. I'm not playing that game.
What's up?
Listen,
so we can see.
I'm just going to say this. I am A-OK. I think birth control was created for women, and I think it's a great thing. I mean,
I think that you're a chauvinist, but I'll let you have that.
Since when have I been a chauvinist? I think I've been pretty awesome. But listen,
I think for that statement, simply just show the video.
We're going to show the video.
Animals, it's worked for 6 months. But
it's been tested already.
So do men take pills or?
So we basically could see it as. I mean, there's like 7 different versions of it for women. There's the shot. There's the pill. There's like a million pills. And then there's the ring. And of course, there's the diaphragm. Then there's the female condom. All right, so all the different pills. I'm going to just put up 5 fingers for all the pills.
Okay.
Then we have the depot shot. Then we have the Nuvo ring. Then we have the diaphragm. Then we have...
You said diaphragm already.
Did I say diaphragm? Wait, no.
Yeah, you did.
All the pills, the shot... The Nuva ring, no I didn't. Then the diaphragm.
Okay.
Then the female condom, then regular condoms, and...
But regular condom is not for women, that's for men.
It's not, no, okay, it's for
men. You're talking birth control in general, or are you talking birth control for women?
But the whole concept of a male pill being taken.
Mm-hmm.
You know what, let me take out the... male condom, so we'll leave it at 9.
Thank you.
He has 1 out of 10.
And I take that one with pleasure.
Saying is this, like I said, it's way easier to unload a gun than to shoot at a bulletproof vest, period. So if there was a way for you to be proactive about your sexual health and that of the partners that you sleep with,
mm-hmm.
why not do that?
Isn't a condom sexual health, though?
I agree. I definitely think that it is.
So
but
why try to fix something that's not broken?
Condoms prevent... sexually transmitted diseases as well as pregnancy. Now,
that sounds perfect to me.
Now, long story short, all I'm saying is, okay, is that if you have the opportunity to do it, I don't see anything wrong with that.
Let's just agree to disagree, because me as a man, I didn't take it 20 years ago. I'm not going to start taking it now. Well, not 20, because I'm only, you know, but still. We'll just agree to disagree, and that's okay. That's okay.
Next topic.
Yes. Next topic. Oscar Pistorius, this guy has now been given 5 years in prison, and apparently it's one of the apartheid prisons at that. So,
oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's terrible.
So, I mean, I don't know. Should we? How do you feel about that? Because what he did was, he on Valentine's Day, he killed his girlfriend. He shot her through the bathroom.
We have a video of it. We can show just some of the decision coming from the court.
On count two, the contravention of section 120, subsection 3B of the Firearms Control Act, number 60 of 2000. The sentence imposes 3 years imprisonment, wholly suspended for 5 years, on condition that within the period of suspension, the accused is not found guilty of a crime where there is negligence involving the use of a firearm. You may be seated.
So he's basically facing 5 years?
5 years,
but
in prison.
But potentially it's going to mean house arrest.
So what
explain the, that. Run it down, because you,
so
you
basically,
did a little bit more.
Yeah, I did a little research on this, and basically he's been given 5 years in prison, and they're saying that he could possibly get out if he's on good behavior in 10 months. But now they're also saying that these 5 years could become house arrest. Now, this guy is an Olympic gold medalist.
Mm-hmm.
He has a lot of money. So him being on house arrest, and he's a double amputee. So they call him the Blade Runner. So he doesn't have his legs, for people who don't know.
Oh, little thing.
That's how you feel?
Yeah.
Okay. So, so basically, that's just what it is. And since this man has money and he lives in South Africa, and this is where everything happened, if he lives in, if he's, since he lives in South Africa and he has all this money at his house, I mean, he's okay. Like, you know, if you have millions of dollars and you were acquitted of killing somebody, but your probation is house arrest, I mean, that's a win.
We're turning up
every night. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Unless there are stipulated things in there where he can't drink and he can't have company.
Right, because if it's house arrest, and then he has to have a certain, like, he's gonna have drug tests per certain amount of drug and alcohol tests.
Right.
So he can't turn up every night, and he doesn't know when the assigned officer to his case may or may not show up, and
right,
at the certain time or day or night or whatever. But I mean, I don't know all the stipulations of that, because I heard a similar story like years ago where a father had actually accidentally shot his daughter because
multiple times.
I think he shot her twice. It may have been once or twice. It was a little girl. She wasn't like older than maybe like 10 or 12.
Okay.
And she was hiding in the closet in the house. And when she jumped out to like play basically like hide and seek kind of with her dad, like he had come into the house.
They're playing peekaboo?
Something to that extent. He basically like, he shot her by accident because he didn't know who or what, whatever was
did
in the
she
house.
Did she die with the lights
she did,
out?
She did die.
Oh, wow.
So, and the lights were out. I have to find the story and I can pull it up. But like the whole thing was just like, that's kind of the game you play,
right,
that's very dangerous. I mean, at the same time, who doesn't love that secret, sensual, sexy surprise from your significant other? You would hope that it would never lead to that type of ending. But it's kind of like, now here we are in the end of it all. So he was acquitted of it.
Mm-hmm.
And then he was given these 5 years, you said, because he was acquitted here in the United States? Or
No. This all happened in South Africa.
It didn't happen in South Africa.
Yeah, so apparently there are like different judicial rules in South Africa.
Okay.
So apparently he was acquitted of it, but then they said they would still have to try to find some sort, because he was supposed to get like life in prison, or maybe even the death penalty. I'm not sure they do that. That's extreme or over-exaggerating. But they said that even though he was acquitted, something had to happen. So they gave him a minimum of, or a maximum of 5 years in prison. So I don't know.
But that's messy.
Right.
Oh.
So I don't know.
I digress. Go ahead. You can have all of that.
You got this lipstick on today. What's up with this lipstick? What kind of lipstick is this? It matches your hair.
This is Vitamin E lipstick in the color of mahogany. And it's fall colors. You know, kind of keep it warm, keep it inviting.
Okay.
You know, favorite color of my favorite wine. I love a good, deep, rich red wine.
Red wine.
So, I mean, it's just kind of one of those things that just worked with all of the bright light, like the blazer, the jewelry, everything.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted something to kind of tie it all in together, you know. So,
red wine is an acquired taste.
Red wine is an acquired taste because I used to hate red wine.
Do you prefer red wine or white wine? Like, if you had to choose, if somebody came to you and was like, listen, which wine do you want? Red or white? You can't say them both. So, which one would you say?
Hey, Mom. And I have a Honda Accord. It's my little helper. I would drink red wine with a straw. Because I hate that red wine can stain your teeth. I'm very adamant about my smile.
So, you would do red wine over white wine with a straw?
Red wine with a straw.
So, if you couldn't do a straw, you would do white wine?
I would do white wine.
Okay. I just do white wine. Red wine with a nice dinner, a nice steak. We're gonna start having like wine on the show because I just wanna be able to just
right about that.
Drink and talk about whatever comes to mind. What song is this? Oh, Wiz Khalifa and, oh, okay. I don't think I've ever heard this song before.
Just listen. Hey.
That's how you feel?
Hey.
That's how you feel?
That's how I felt.
Oh, okay. She's turning up right now. That's because she had a lot more wine than I did before the show started.
Jealousy is a terrible thing.
Oh man, I'm so envious right now.
I think, how much time do we have? Because I know that we have some timeline topics.
Back to the great old timeline topics.
Woo! Because they're always entertaining. They are always hilarious. They are always...
I think
funny.
That
I got a couple
listen,
things pulled
no,
up.
I want to let's do the timeline topic about the mother who danced for her daughter. Was it her daughter or her son?
I don't remember. Hold on. Let me pull it up here. It's a young lady who's dancing. She's dancing.
Yeah, she's dancing for her son inside of his room.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Well, that's what I thought. I said she was in her son's room. That may not be right, but what did she say at the end? She's talking about cancer, right?
Yeah, so she danced for her son or daughter, but I think it was son to cheer them up because they had cancer, and she said that they're such a fighter.
Mm-hmm.
It was a great thing, so we're going to get into that right now.
We're going to show you this video. Give us 1 second. It's coming. Ooh, wait, I clicked the wrong thing.
No, it was there.
Our music is still up. Hold up. There we go. Now, so she's dancing for her son or daughter, and she's basically telling them that they're such a fighter and how extraordinary they are because
I'm 7 of chemo, and I chose to
they are going to fight cancer, and they're going to win
selection.
Today.
Not that I'm very good at the dance, so
I
just
go ahead and take a look at this
because I am not a follower. I am the leader of my own weird band, so here goes nothing. I hope you enjoy it for chemo day. Trying to stay away. I know it's like I get too close to the camera and it's kind of freaky. So whatever.
First of all, Mom is super cute. Yes, with her little stands. I see you. Hey, get it, Mommy.
I do my own thing. So if you feel like it, get up and do it with me.
What?
Yo, she's so cool.
Hey, go, Mommy. Catch the dougie? Did you catch how she hit the dougie?
Anyways. I love you. You're gonna kick cancer's ass today. Yeah, I know it, because you're a badass sister. I love you with all my heart, all my soul, and that's about it for today. I love you. Adore you. I admire you.
That was so cute.
Yo, that was beautiful, man.
That was sweet.
That was really, really beautiful, yo. Shout out to the moms and dads who are out there supporting their children during one of the hardest things they ever have to go through, which is cancer, especially at a young age.
Shout out to all the women, young women, everybody fighting breast cancer right now. Shout out to Shay Sharp. Shay, I love you, girl. You are a fighter and you are a winner. Everybody go follow her at SSPW on Instagram, Shay Sharp's Pink Wishes on Facebook. She was diagnosed with breast cancer at the age of 26.
Wow.
And she created an organization where she actually was able to grant wishes to women who were terminal and okay. diagnosed under the age of 40. Because if you think about cancer, like breast cancer specifically, mm-hmm. they talk about it for women who are over the age of 40. So sadly, the cancer has come back now and she is 36.
Shay Sharp, don't worry. We know you're going to beat it just like you did the last time.
We're going to do a video and dance like mama did for you or something. It's going down.
Yeah.
So that was just so awesome. And we definitely appreciate the love and positivity that people put out in the universe because yeah. it changes lives. So
the next video we're going to show you all is the racist video. I think this video, it's just a very, very funny video. So let's get into it.
Game of Thrones is my shit.
Man, that's what I love about you. It's like you're a black dude, but you don't act black.
What?
What I mean is like you don't act all like thugged out.
Oh, so all black people are thugged out?
Man, oops, I was racist. Black guy, come here.
How can I help you?
I was trying to bond with my black coworker. Things got racist real fast.
Hey man, he's all right. He's a really good guy. What yeah. he meant to say was is that he finds it extremely refreshing that you yeah. managed to somehow yeah. defy racial stereotypes, right. remain your own person, rooted but not bound to the black experience, which is culturally astonishing for him because he comes from Milwaukee and his father's a redneck.
He said all that.
He's cool, all man. That. He ain't got a auntie house all the time, man. Eat place of food.
Love her. It's good food.
He's a good guy.
Yeah, if you say so.
Thank God for racism insurance.
There when you need it most. Racism insurance.
You are so hot. And I'm not into black girls, like, at all. There's something about you.
Wait, excuse me?
Is that your real hair?
What?
Do you have Indian in your family?
You know what?
Oops, I was racist. Black guy, come here.
Really, Keith? That's what you led with. You know what? No, my friend here, he got a little hung up with your beauty.
Wait, y'all are friends?
Me and Keith?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we go way back. Yeah, we was at my crib actually watching BET, having a conversation about how the black woman has an unparalleled beauty. It's second to none.
Black girls rock so hard.
And that was really sweet.
You owe me, Ryan Gosling. You owe me.
Racism insurance. For those times that you just kind of weren't thinking.
It wasn't even my shoes, man. You know? You can't trust these hoes.
Can't trust these hoes.
You can't trust hoes.
Whoa, man. You can't say that.
Why not?
Because we're talking about black hoes. Now, we can call black women hoes,
yeah.
but you can't.
I just thought I couldn't say nigga.
Oh,
nigga,
come here! What
the hell is wrong with you, man? You cannot use the N-word. It's not covered in your policy, man. Oh, yeah, you on your own. Hey, man.
Fucked up.
Please don't jump me. Please.
We not gonna jump you. What do you think this is? We're in Westwood, man.
Yeah, bro. We just gonna intellectually denigrate and scold you for the abuse of your white privilege.
What's white privilege?
Racism insurance. For everything but the N-word.
Really? Really?
I want to learn! I want to learn!
So, sibling rivalry, I think is a very, very interesting thing. So, what would you do in an event like this? Because I used to bicker with my little brother all the time as a child.
Mm-hmm.
And, but I don't know if it ever got this extreme. So, let's just take a look at it. Yo, that was crazy.
You heard that echo through his soul, came out one ear, hit the wall, came back.
But do you know what I continue to think about, though?
What?
Who was recording it?
Mom or dad.
I hope it wasn't mom or dad, yo.
And, or maybe it could have been a cousin. It could have been anybody, honestly. I got picked on by my older cousin. So it was kind of like this cycle. You kind of had to get
initiated. You had to pledge. You had to be hazing to the family.
We didn't do no hazing.
Well, if you're initiating somebody, then there's some sort of hazing going on.
No, you had certain criteria of rituals that you had to follow.
It sounds like
handle a certain situation when you meet with another family member, or you have to understand the hierarchy between you and another person in the family. So it's kind of like one of those things, like, you know a child's place, so you knew your place. But it wasn't like
So you pick on somebody and they can't do anything, so they need to know their place. Sounds like a bit of hazing to me.
Well, can you explain hazing? Because you're great.
I prefer not to.
Exactly.
Kappa Psi is a non-hazing fraternity. Anywho, let's get back into the next topic. What would you do if you were at a wedding, or you were the one getting married, and then they asked, if anybody who doesn't think that these people should be wedded, please speak now. If somebody actually did it. I've never been at a wedding.
Not that it happened, but have you ever been at a wedding and they said,
and you thought about it? And you thought about standing up and saying something?
Yeah.
No, because if that's the case, you don't belong at that wedding.
Now, I get what he's saying on that aspect. At the same time, the person who was getting married, like, she was my girl, like, for everything.
Okay.
We are not at all close anymore.
But you know what sucks, though? Because the wedding is already paid for. So if somebody steps up and says, no, don't do it, technically, you're already married because you already went to City Hall, right?
You already got the...
You're already married because you have the certificate. So why ruin a great event? Why ruin a great moment?
I've seen some people get left at the altar, like on like reality shows and stuff, but let's just show this video and then you'll get our frame of reference because this is a hot mess.
James and Linda's wedding ceremony.
Why? You may not be offering him. She already
offered him. She's tired.
And this is the part where the minister says, if anyone knows any reason why these two should not be wed, speak now or forever hold your peace. That's James' ex-girlfriend, Karen.
I would like to say that when I took him out to me for 6 years, when I asked him about Linda, he told me she's nothing but a freak. She ain't got no more, she ain't got no shadow.
Looks like Karen couldn't hold come on, like, turn up? For a second.
She said, come on, like, she threw hands.
And now, wedlock becomes gridlock as the wedding party takes sides and starts duking it out. So much for the wedding ceremony. This bride promised to take her husband for better or for worse, but it can't get any worse than this.
Yo, that is crazy. Insane.
That's a hot, and obviously that was dated from like a little ways back.
Right.
But at the same time.
So would you invite your ex to your wedding? Any of your exes? Because you think they might do that?
First of all, none of you will ever be in the disclosed location, which I'm obviously not going
to
say here.
Never, ever, 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 ever invite your ex to your wedding.
Next topic.
Yeah, do you have a quote that you want to share?
I do have a quote that I want to share. And it says, he who lacks the courage to pursue his purpose will lack the passion to ravish your soul. Well,
you wanna dive in on that?
All I'm gonna say is this. It kind of makes me think of not only being in a relationship with someone, but being a parent in the future. The two individuals as we sit here are to you as you watch the show. How dare we tell you to try to be as amazing, extraordinary, and suave in every aspect of your life if we don't try ourselves? Because we had the audacity to try it at some point.
Absolutely.
I think so. Once you start to find what you love and what you're about and what really lights the fire within your soul is who you are, it then can only lead to you just loving more about the world and the life that is around you, the people that are with you. Mm. And that leads to better relationships, better interactions, healthier interactions and relationships, more authentic versions of who you are to the world. And then from there, you can inspire others to do the same.
I mean, it sounds good. I mean, I know.
He ready
to
go to his. We're going to let go ahead. Go ahead.
So listen, mine comes from recently passed Oscar De La Renta, and what he said was, fashion is about dressing accordingly to what's fashionable. Style is more about being yourself. So obviously, fashion comes and goes, but style, it just speaks for itself. You know, if you like something, if something stays with you, if something resonates with you, being able to put something together and calling it your own, that's style. Fashion will die off and style is eternal. So that's just all I really need to say about the topic. Rest in peace one more time to the great Oscar De La Renta. You have inspired millions of lives and you will surely, surely, surely be missed. That's our time on Suave Life TV. I want to thank everybody for tuning in. Look forward to the next episode. Everything will soon be up. We're going to turn up. We're going to drink up. We're going to do all that.
Or not.
Or no, I just got a little bit excited because that's what I do, you know, I get excited. But once again, man, thanks for watching Suave Life TV with the great and beautiful Brytnei Elle. And we look forward to you seeing what we do. Stay suave, my friends.
Bye, guys.